title, you know, 91 The Year Punk Broke, was just something just kind of came out of my mouth on the first day of the tour. We were in Cork, Ireland. We were suffering massive jet lag from our cross-continental ride, and sitting around watching Euro MTV, and Motley Crue comes on, and they're doing this version of Anarchy in the UK in this European arena in front of, you know, hundreds of thousands of people, and that pretty much set the tone of what was to come. We found a lot of strange things happening, you know, when we were on this tour. And Sonic Youth were playing to the largest crowds they've ever played to, and of course, they brought along Nirvana as an opening act at the time. It was about a month and a half before Nevermind. And in addition to all the things that we were seeing on this tour, just, you know, like on television and in fashion magazines, you know, we just saw that, you know, punk rock was finally, being digested, you know, at large.
There are five oranges. No, there are six that are being hidden by the grapes. Now I'll eat every grape. Then there is the kiwis. There is only four kiwis because they're so precious. It's a fruit you don't find everywhere.
A few situations I did sort of coax with the film, but I basically let people, you know, run ragged with you know, where they were at that point in time. And, you know, I mean, basically the tour was just a blast. It was just 2.5 weeks. It was short, so didn't have too much time for people to go insane. But, you know, it was a short tour. It was just a lot of fun, you know. I think that comes across in the film.
Diamond fans probably will not flock to see Dave Markey's film 1991, The Year Punk Broke, featuring Sonic Youth.
Punk rock has been around for, you know, 16 years or so, and for many years it, you know, it only existed on this very underground level, and finally it seems we got to a point where, you know, it could be digested and embraced by pop culture at large. I think you stop being a punk when you're a teenager, but then again, there's certain people that will hold on to that sort of teenage brattiness, that defiance, that the uneasy emotional years of adolescence and post-adolescence that, you know, some people just don't lose at all. You know?